We have Alex Vozik in camp with Teddy Atlas. I talked to Alex. He says, you're a very genuine guy. You're an honest guy. What's it like to train Alex Vozik for Adonis Stevenson?
What's it like?
Yes. It's your first time training him, of course.
It's like being with a good person every day. A person that I feel good being around. And that I'm happy to be around. That's what it feels like. And it feels like a person that he wants to learn. And I can show him things, and I know he's committed to learning them, or to trying to pick them up and put them to use.
Teddy, you guys are going into the Lions Den, Adonis Stevenson. What does Alex need to do to win, to take the belt away from Adonis?
Yeah, he needs to do the things we're working on, part of those things. And he needs to go in there and control the ring in his way. You know, not allow Stevenson to control geography the way he likes to control geography, where he wants to fight the fight so much. And the same thing that people have had to do for 200 years since the sport started. Hit the other guy and don't let the guy hit him.
After I'll keep a very short rapid fire here. Broner, Pacquiao, break it down.
Pacquiao, you know, it's not indicative. The Matisse fight's not indicative of what he might have left, because Matisse had nothing left. So don't go by that. I don't know how much Pacquiao has left, but you might find out in the Broner fight, because Broner's young enough and physical enough and talented enough and fast enough where if he's right for that fight, if he's in shape and mentally right for that fight, he could give Pacquiao more than he expected.
What did you make of the Canelo deal? $365 million, the highest sports contract in sports history.
God bless them. Fighters can't make enough money for me. They let them make as much as they can. As long as they can make it, let them make it. They're in that ring risking everything. They've missed part of their childhood. The kid that I'm training for that title, that's why I want for him and his family. You know, of course I get something too. But for them, I want them to be able to be champion. They deserve it. He deserves it. Because you know how many birthday parties he had to give up? You know how many
no prom,
Christmases,
no dating,
no
yep.
proms. Or people don't think about those things.
You're right.
Things that everyone does when they're a kid. They gave them all up. And so now they have a chance to make money. Let them make as much as they can. And they have to get in that ring where it's dangerous and scary. Let them make as much as they can.
A couple more and I'm done. Floyd Mayweather, does he come back or not? What do you think, Teddy?
If you put a check out there with enough zeros on it and it fits and the kind of fight fits him, because he's a smart guy and he shouldn't be knocked for being smart. Why should we knock someone for being smart? He's a smart guy. He's a smart manager, a business manager. He's a smart fighter. Why should we hate a guy for being smart? I give him all the credit in the world.
Okay.
If somebody's going to put enough zeros on that check and it's the landscape that's right for him, yeah, he's
take
gonna.
It. Crawford, Spence, who do you like in that one?
You know, you can make an argument both ways. If you put a gun to my head, you could probably say that, you know, Spence, younger, bigger, you know, just naturally bigger, huge, huge guy for welterweight, relentless. You know, that maybe a little edge, but I'm not counting out Crawford. I'm not counting out Crawford because Crawford's special. So Crawford would turn around and say, Teddy, you just made that argument. Well, how about the argument? And he'd be 1,000% right. How about the argument for me? And I'll make the argument for him right now. Crawford would say, how about me being more rangy? How about me having a longer reach? How about me keeping him at the end of my punches and making him pay a price to be aggressive and turning his aggression into a problem for him? So it'd
okay.
be interesting.
Two more questions and we're done with this interview. Thank you so much, Teddy Atlas. What do you think of Usyk if he beats Tony Bellew and he moves up to fight Anthony Joshua?
Yeah, first of all, he's going to beat Bellew. He's going to win that fight. Usyk's the best.
The biggest secret. I call him the biggest secret in boxing.
Listen, he's the best cruiserweight out there. I had him rated in my top 10. So,
but you know boxing. Most people don't.
It wasn't that much of a secret. But, you know, he's probably the most dominant cruiserweight since Holyfield. You know, most people won't remember that. But he it's very interesting. He obviously, Joshua's a big guy. You know, he's the new prototype heavyweights. I mean, they're not 205, they're not 215, they're not 220, they're not 230 anymore. They're huge.
He's an action figure.
Yeah, he really. That's a good way of putting it. So, yeah, But again, just like when we made the argument a second ago about Crawford versus Spence. Yeah, you make the argument the guy's too big for him, but what about the advantages Crawford has? That maybe he'd be too intellectual for him. Maybe he'd be too long for him. Maybe he'd be too good a counterpuncher for him. Well, that's exactly the argument Usyk would make, and the smart people around him, the Lomachenkos, very smart people. And they would make the argument, yeah, that's his strength. What about our strengths? We're going to be quicker. We're going to be smarter. We're going to be faster. So, he's special. You know, it's not just another guy going up there to make money. This is a guy who's a gold medalist from the Olympics. This is a guy who's an undefeated professional champion who won a world title in like 10 fights. Yeah.
And he beat Murat Kasayev when no one gave him a shot.
Exactly. Okay. So put all that into it.
In this interview, Teddy, can I please have your top five pound-for-pound fighters right now, if you could line them up?
If I can remember. Okay. Lomachenko, Crawford, Spence. I used to have Thurman in there, but he's not active.
Mikey?
He's not active anymore. Oh, you want me to put Mikey? You wanted to
put
your
list?
No, my list.
Your list. You said,
No, I thought maybe it was your list. You sure? So we have...
Loma, Crawford.
Yeah, Spence. I guess Garcia obviously is not a bad pick. Tell me who all the guys are.
Canelo, Triple G. You have a Wilder.
Listen, Canelo, just the fights that he's fought. I'm not putting Wilder in there because... First of all, he hasn't fought that level of guy except Ortiz, and his technique is not up to that. His power is. He's the hardest puncher in
boxing. Canelo, you started saying something.
Canelo, look, I could put Canelo somewhere in the top five, I guess, five, six.
Okay.
Because, he's fought Golovkin. He's shown that he's a certain level by being involved in two of those fights. He's shown he's a certain level. And he's a guy on the improve. I see improvement in that guy. You know, I see him getting technically better. I don't want a guy who's just strong and who's just aggressive and just fan-friendly and just a good puncher. I want the technique to be part of it. I want the intellect to be part of it. And he has gotten better. So I guess to make you happy, I'll put Garcia in there. We got five, I guess. But I have trouble remembering.
Usyk?
Yeah, Usyk is, you got to think about him. The only thing I'd say about him is let him fight maybe one or two more real top-level guys. You know, I mean, he's fought the best in the cruiserweights, but let's qualify that.
Okay.
Are the best in the cruiserweights top-level guys.
Okay.
In general.
I understand. Charlos?
I like the Charlos. I have him in my top 10, you know, but again, let them fight a little bit more. Let them show us, which I think they will. I really do. Let them show us that it's kind of what Sugar Ray Leonard showed us when he fought Duran, that it's more than just a talented guy, that there's substance of other things called character and all those things that we love to talk about, that's there too, which I think it is there. But let us see us with that kind of opponent.
Absolutely.
To feel good about that.
Before I forget, does Tank Davis remind you of Mike Tyson? He reminds me a lot of Tyson, the way he moves, the way 19 knockouts, personality.
No. Yeah. You guys, everyone reminds you guys of Tyson. If a guy does this and comes forward, all of a sudden, that's Mike Tyson. Please.
All right. Teddy Atlas, thank you so much. Right. Stay tuned. December 1st in Canada. Don't miss it. Teddy Atlas, Alex Vozic, EsNewsReporting.com, Elie Seckbach, reporting.